Welcome to World News Channel. If you are new on this station, please click on the red subscription button. And don't forget to click on the notification bell icon to get updates or trending news. Today we'll talk about the danger of the use of chemicals as food enhancers. Health experts and dietitians in the Northeast have called for urgent steps to check the rampant application of enhancers by food sellers in the country. The call is coming just as the National Agency for Food and Drug Administration and Control, NAFDAC, in states within the sub-region said they had commenced strict monitoring of restaurant operators. Reports in some part of the country indicate that some food sellers have resorted to the use of paracetamol to reduce the cost of cooking energy while boiling meat, just as some of them also applied bleach on cassava used in preparation of local food, which is gari. Health experts, dietitians, and medical laboratory personnel have warned on the danger of such food enhancers to the health of the people, saying the chemicals contained in those items and other unconventional enhancers cause enormous damage to human organs over time. NAFDAC and health officials in Bauchi, Gombe, Borno, Adamawa, and neighboring Jigawa said although the use of paracetamol and bleach in preparing food was not common in their states, there was a need to enhance surveillance and intensify enlightenment as a proactive measure. Mr. Gonzok Nokom, Gombe State Coordinator of NAFDAC, said they were yet to discover any case of use of paracetamol to soften meat in any part of the state, saying the most disturbing unwholesome practice in the state was the adulteration of palm oil. We never recorded any case of use of paracetamol as an enhancer for food. It could be happening, but we are yet to discover it. This is a fight for everyone, not just NAFDAC alone. Food enhancers are hazardous to our health. Paracetamol on its own is a very bad friend of the liver, as high doses are toxic to it, he said. He warned that the use of food enhancers could result in food poisoning, saying his agency has been gathering fruit sellers on a periodic basis to sensitize them on the danger of using calcium carbide to ripen fruits. He urged residents of Gombe State to be vigilant and report suspected cases of such activities that could threaten the health of Nigerians. In Bauchi, Alhaji Ibrahim Adamu, Zonal Director, Northeast NAFDAC, said the agency had been alerted over the practice of ripening of fruits with calcium carbide and use of paracetamol tablets in food processing in some states. He said this practice is considered a great danger to health, which should not be allowed to continue. Dr. Bako Mohammed, Permanent Secretary, Bauchi State Ministry of Health, said the state government had all the structures to monitor and inspect food processing. He said they have been partnering NAFDAC and NDLEA, monitoring such misuse of drugs, assuring that state governments will intensify efforts on creating awareness. Dr. Mohammed explained that drugs, unless prescribed, are poisonous, saying cooking paracetamol changes its chemical composition. He explained that paracetamol is an analgesic, and when taken ordinarily, went through the normal process of digestion and kills pains in the body. But then it gets heated by using any firing mechanism, it will hydrolyze and produce 4-aminophenol, which can cause kidney failure and also affect the liver. He advised that health education and monitoring should be carried out by the National Orientation Agency, NAFDAC and NDLEA. The Executive Director of the Non-Governmental Organization Bauchi, Dr. Albert Gattis, said that paracetamol is not a drug to be taken on a regular basis. He said paracetamol is used for the treatment of mild illnesses, moderate pains from headaches, backaches, toothaches, flu, and to reduce fever, among others. Gadi said some household restaurants and bars had been using paracetamol to soften meat to reduce the cost of energy used in cooking. He warned that paracetamol, when cooked, loses its painkiller property and becomes highly acidic and dangerous for human consumption. On its part, Adamawa government said it had to set up a food safety committee to check the use of food enhancers in preparation of food by food vendors and restaurant operators in the state. Also speaking, the Adamawa coordinator of NAFDAC, Mr. Jamil Laudu, said his office has been alerted on the use of enhancers, particularly paracetamol tablets in food preparation by some Nigerians. Aoudi said the practice was dangerous to health, adding that NAFTAC officials in the state had swung into action in enlightening the public. He advised the use of meat tenderizers, which are sold in powder or liquid form, instead of the application of paracetamol. When the drug is used for cooking, it is hydrolyzed into 4-aminophenol, which is highly toxic to the kidney. Also, the high consumption of analgesics over many years is a well-known cause of kidney damage. Paracetamol poisoning usually causes liver failure, which may also be accompanied by acute renal failure, he alerted. He said that negative impacts included raising the level of potassium in the blood system, which could damage the kidneys, and also cause a heart condition called cardiomyopathy. Toughness of meat comes from the connective tissues during cooking. It slowly breaks down into a substance called gelatin, and the meat becomes soft. Without using paracetamol, you can tenderize meat by cooking with a pressure cooker or soaking the meat in a highly concentrated salt water solution before cooking. Also, slicing the meat will help severe muscle fibers, thereby hastening to soften while cooking, said Marie. Following directives from the agency's headquarters, NAFTAC QB officers swung into action, visiting and inspecting most of the restaurants located in the state. Their findings in Damaturu, Gashua, Putiskum, and the local government did not indicate any of the restaurants using paracetamol or any other enhancers to process food. Similarly, caterers and food vendors denied the usage of any enhancer to hasten cooking or preservation of food. The practice may be prevalent among communities who consume cow skin, also known as omo, and that menu is not popular here. So the NAFTAC has one little action to try to stop people who engage in this practice. Okay guys, what do you have to say about this? People making use of chemicals like carbide, paracetamol, which is dangerous to the body, in preserving food so as to maximize their gain. Leave your comments in the comment section. Thank you very much.